Attention campers, please circle up. For our next activity at Camp KPL, we're going to visit Counselor Kenny at the animal farm. As always, I ask you to please do not feed the animals. If they want Sloppy Joes, they can come to the mess hall just like everyone else and serve themselves. To the animal farm!
That's right, Kenny. Hey,
that's
boys,
right,
and
yep.
girls, it's me, Uncle Luigi.
Indeed it is.
I'm at the animal farmer's store tailor.
Yes, you are.
And I got a classic for you today, boys and girls.
Oh, good, a classic. That's great.
Sit back and relax. This is a good one. Mm-hmm. This is the story of the Pied Piper.
The Pied Piper.
That's right.
Okay. What? Listen, Uncle Lou, I'm sorry. I hate to interrupt you. Listen, you gotta understand, this doesn't have anything to do with baked goods, okay? When we say pie...
Everybody loves a pie.
I know that.
What do you got against pie?
I have nothing against pie. I love pie myself. But pied, in this case, doesn't refer to pies.
Term pied is most likely a reference to the French word pied, which is spelled the same way, and it means foot, and it's probably a reference to someone who would travel from town to town on foot selling their wares or services.
Oh.
Duh.
Okay. Yes, right. Sorry. I didn't... Go ahead.
Anyway, I was saying...
Yes, like you were saying. Guys, you were. Sorry.
Once upon a time...
Wow.
There was a beautiful village. And it sat at the base of a beautiful mountain in a beautiful valley, and it was filled with beautiful people. Everything in the town was beautiful and happy, except for the poo stinky.
The what?
The poo stinky.
The poo stinky?
Yeah, poo stinky.
Poo
what
stinky?
Do you not understand about poo stinky?
Nothing. I just don't... What do you mean by poo stinky?
What? You see this beautiful town at the base of this beautiful mountain, filled with beautiful people, had everything that everyone could ask for except for plumbing. Yeah, they did not have the plumbing. There was no way to get the poo stinky out of the house except for to carry my buckets, and that was stinky and smelling and disgusting.
Yes, I bet it was. Okay.
So the whole village did not smell very, very good, especially since they were in the valley and the drainage wasn't so good, and then, you know, it kind of had a swamp, you know? Boys and girls, you ever have a sump pump and it back up into your yard and it gets all sticky, but and the smells kind of... That's what the whole village smelled like, really.
Okay.
It was gross.
We get it. It's gross. Poo stinky.
So that's why the mayor of the town, he decided he's gonna get some professional help. And so, as luck would have it, he meets a traveler who visits the town that very day, and this traveler is a piper.
A piper?
Now, as we all know, a piper is somebody who lays pipes, which, of course, is what we use in plumbing.
Wait a second.
So this piper...
I'm sorry. I think you're confused. It's a plumber that you're talking about.
No, I'm talking about a piper, Kenny.
No, you're talking about a plumber. A plumber's the guy that actually fixes plumbing.
No, a piper lays pipes.
Yes, but a plumber...
What does a plumber do?
A plumber fixes stuff.
What does a plumber fix?
Well, a plumber fixes pipes.
Thank you very
much. No, but
that's all I'm saying.
Yeah, but it's a different kind of thing, okay?
Jeez, first the pies, now the pie. I don't know. What are your problems?
Nothing. Forget it. Go ahead. I don't care. Whatever.
Anyway, the piper... He says, sure, I'll be happy to help you with your poo stinky problem, Mr. Mayor, but it's a big job. It's going to cost you. Because I got to put pipes down for the whole town. It's a big job, you know. The piper, he's going to have to call his cousin. They're going to have to bring in extra workers. Going to have a backhoe. It's likely to take 3-4 weeks minimum just to lay the groundwork, you know. But the mayor, he said, I pay you, I promise. And the piper, he's a nice guy. He doesn't even ask for a deposit. He just begins the work right away. Well, it takes 3, maybe 4 weeks, but soon the whole town is smelling like a rose because there is no more poo stinky. The pipes, they go right up to the toilet and the bad-smelling stuff go right out of town. It's a beautiful thing. Everybody got indoor plumbing. Everybody happy. Everybody smell good. The piper, he go back to the mayor, and he say, Mr. Mayor, I'm finished, and here is my beer. Well, the mayor, he's a josh, he hit the floor. He's a freak, you know. He says, I had no idea it was gonna be so expensive. I cannot pay this. These are ridiculous. And the piper, he said, but you promised. I told you it was gonna be a big job. I told you it was gonna be expensive. And the mayor said, I'm sorry. I cannot pay this. But here, have this lovely pie. Now, this was no ordinary pie. This was a delicious pie. This was little blueberry, little apple in there. It was a mixed fruit, mixed berry pie. And the piper, it was so good that he forgot about collecting. And he went home. About a day or two go by, he realized I never get paid from the mayor. So he called up the mayor. He sent the past due notices. He sent bill after bill after bill. Nothing. Finally, he goes back to the mayor again. He says, Mr. Mayor, you still owe me for that big piping job I did for you. And Mr. Mayor said, I did not know it was going to cost so much money. I do not have it. But here, have another one of these delicious pies. And the piper, he ate the pie. And again, it was so delicious, he forget all about the beer. He go home. Few days later, he realized he still never got billed, never got paid. He's looking around at all of his bills. He's got to pay contractors, subcontractors. He's got to contact his union. He's threatening legal action. He's calling up the mayor every day. Finally, he go back down there to see him in person. And the mayor said, once again, I'm sorry, I cannot pay you. But here, have one of these pies. Where the Pied Piper? He eats the pie. Except this time, he's not feeling so good. He eat the whole pie down in one bite, and he's not sitting very well with him. He says, can I use your bathroom for a second? He goes into the bathroom, and wouldn't you know it, out comes the pie. Not just this pie, but the other pie. And the other pie. There's so much pie coming out that you know what happens? That's right, the pipes, they get all blocked up. Pretty soon the whole town can't flush their toilets. Everybody's backing up. Water's everywhere. Pretty soon the poo stinky smell is back. And it's worse than ever. And the mayor said, but Mr. Piper, you gotta help. You gotta help. The poo stinky is back and it's worse than ever. But the piper said, no. I'm sorry, I cannot help you. Because you did not pay the piper.
Okay.
The moral of the story, boys and girls, is that everybody loves a pie.
Everybody loves pie.
But nothing beats a cold hard cash.
Gee, Uncle Lou, that was touching. Thank you very much for that.
I think so too. It chokes me up a little bit.
Oh, yeah, I can tell. Yeah, yeah.
And kind of makes me hungry for pie, too, you know?
Me too, yeah, of course, yeah. Everybody loves pie.